This year I noticed that our students are excited about math. We have implemented the Open Up Math resources. I've noticed that the curriculum has high levels of engagements in the classroom. The curriculum provides focus, task alignment, a student-centered approach to the lesson design with all of our learners in mind. It differentiates for our ESL students, our AG students, EC, and regular ed students. The biggest shift I have noticed from last year to this current school year is how our students are constructing mathematically sound arguments. The curriculum also facilitates productive struggle for our learners. It's extremely nice to go into a classroom and hear heated dialogues among students and teachers about content and students arguing with each other to make sure that their points are heard. And so that's extremely refreshing.
I'm Sadie Daniels and I teach 7th grade math and accelerated math.
Kelly Nelson and I teach 7th grade math and I do math resource for our exceptional children.
To prepare for the lessons, one thing that we found was really helpful is to print out the student version without the teacher guide and work through it as if we were the students and find areas where we thought maybe the instructions were confusing or they would need more of a graphic to understand what was going on. And Kelly, from her background, is able to tell me where they're going to struggle. As far as pacing goes, we do have to go in a much slower pace with our inclusion classroom, but it is effective that the Open Up works with them as long as you are supplementing it with some graphic organizers. So they need more instructions about what exactly they're looking for, the way it's designed, if there's lots of pictures and visuals or things are labeled, that really helps them understand it. And then supplementing it with extra practice. So when we go at a slower pace, since Open Up has about 5 or 6 practice problems, sometimes they need more practice. So we might supplement that, this working on that same skill or concept, but another day of just kind of going through it before we move on to the next lesson.
This year it's a bit different. It's more visual and the way they teach it.
I am Sarah Vaughn and I teach 8th grade math at Northwest Middle School. At first it was a little bit overwhelming and then magic started to happen. The concepts repeat themselves over and over again, but not in a boring way, in a really fun and exciting way that builds confidence for the kids that they're excited about. Their materials are so good. I can't imagine creating something of this caliber.
It helped me a lot because some people has other ideas on how they do something, and it sometimes easier on what they do than what I do.
So for Open Up resources, the thing I think I like the most is the fact that it takes a lot of the pressure of the instruction off of the teacher and allows us to actually guide the kids instead of just lecture-based teaching. For me, the materials helped because we had a teacher resource book that actually told us, you know, if you have ESL students, EC learners, hey, these are some suggestions that you can use. It gives plenty of opportunity for you to use it straight the way that it's written or be able to take out activities and put in your activity.
I like that we can work in groups and pairs and have the opportunity to explain how we got an answer with our partner.
One of the things that I enjoy most about watching Open Up being implemented into our school is the non-threatening approach it used to complex topics. They were intimidated by mathematics, but Open Up would use topics to get them talking more about math, and then all of a sudden they're going into a concept that they didn't know they was going into. And so because those walls were brought down, students were then able to enter into this math topic with the ability and an open mind to receive the information that's about to be taught.
What I like about math class is how we team together and we partner up and correct each other when we do mistakes, and we can find a way to answer the solution. So there might be like different ways to do it. So each and one of the person in our class have their own unique way to like answer the solution or the problem.
At the beginning, when we first started implementing, it was challenging for me because I felt like we kind of had to reprogram the way that the students thought about math. We had to create that community where students felt comfortable maybe not getting something the first time and being okay with like sharing, hey, this is where I struggled, what's going on, and being willing to open up to other kids about it, because you know, Open Up really encourages them to become problem solvers and to become, you know, to share those different ways of thinking, that just because he did it this way and got to an answer differently than I did doesn't mean that either one of us are incorrect.
What I like about math is that there's multiple ways to get one answer.
I like that we have like different opportunities and everyone who has different learning styles gets to learn their way.
One of the things that you will find that your kids might really like is there are characters that go through these experiences through the Open Up resources, real life people. They'll have a story about Diego struggling with a problem or about Priya going on a walk. My kids actually love these characters, so much so that I think we're going to have a party at the end of the year and they're all going to pick their favorite character and wear a sign and have their Open Up party celebrating their experience all year long with these characters. I found out that these characters are also in the 7th grade and the 6th grade, so by the time the kids get to 8th grade, they are really going to know these characters.
Name all the Open Up characters.
Oh my gosh.
There's Amaya.
Priya.
There's Priya.
Diego, Andre's in there a lot.
Maya.
George.
Diego.
Noah.
Priya, Maya, Diego.
Priya, Jada, Andre, Lynn, Maya.
Kieran. Don, Elena.
Bong Kui Kui.
Yeah.